Good evening. I'm John McCard, Rector of St. James's Episcopal Church. I welcome you for this remembrance service and requiem that we gather this night to remember those we have loved and lost. We'll wait a few more minutes and let everybody join us before we begin. But I invite you to spend this time in silence and reflection. Let us begin. In the name of Christ and his church, I bid you welcome to St. James's this evening. We have come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to mark the 1 year anniversary of the closing of our buildings due to the novel virus COVID-19. In this service, Let us commend to God those who have suffered and died during the pandemic this past year. Grieve our losses of the past year and lift up to God our prayers for all people in the hope given us by the death and resurrection of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. But first, my friends, let us pray together. For all Christian people, as by this requiem, they may be reassured of faithfulness and renewed to fulfill God's and Christ's work in this broken world. Pray too for our bishops, the clergy, and the people of the Diocese of Virginia and the wider Episcopal Church. For the world, which is already Christ's, that those who bear responsibility for its future in politics and industry, in commerce, in education, communication, may be inspired by the good news of Jesus Christ to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom, and peace everywhere. For all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, and the bereaved. God, who is faithful, hear the prayers of our heart in whatever form they may come. As the candles before me are lit this night and throughout this service, I invite you to lift up in your prayers by putting the names of those you love in our chat box. This night we will light 50 candles to commemorate more than 500,000 who have died from COVID-19 and to remember those that we love and care for in this world. Let us now light these candles. We commend all whom we love or who have asked for our prayers this night to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father. And at this time, if you could please mute and let us say together the words that Christ taught us when he said, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and one no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal. Come to me, all ye that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The word of the Lord. At this time, let us share the Faure Requiem and this wonderful musical offering together.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hear the words of Psalm 46. God is our hope and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will we not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the hills be carried into the midst of the sea, through the waters thereof rage and swell, and though the mountains shake at the tempest of the same. There is a river, the streams whereof make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most Highest. God is in the midst of her, therefore shall she not be removed. God shall help her, and that right early. Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations, and I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. May he by whose incarnation gathered into one things both earthly and heavenly, bestow upon you all the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you, now and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.